Hey there! Today I've got a watercolor pencil tutorial for you and I'm gonna show you how to create this landscape. I'm going to use this sketchbook by Hanne Müller. It's a panoramic sketchbook, so it's super long, but I'm gonna use it like a regular sketchbook in this case. And I'm also going to use these Eberhard Faber colored pencils, and I really love those. I got those in Frankfurt at the Creative World Fair, and I love them so much. If you're interested in a review on those, let me know. And I'm gonna list all the supplies that I'm using in the description box down below, just in case you're interested. So at first I did a rough sketch on where everything has to go, and I sketched quite lightly and I blended the colored pencil with the water, and then I sketched and then I blended and so on and so forth. I didn't want to get super dark at first, just building the colors, and I did those shapes you can see here. So I looked at the reference picture a lot. I'm also gonna link the reference picture in the description box if you want to take a look at that one, so you can understand a bit better what I'm talking about here. Unfortunately, the pink in the background completely disappeared after blending, but I'm gonna add it back later on. And it's just super light at this point. There's a path in the foreground here, and I'm using a brown here just to make the first layer of this path. And when I blended it, I decided to make the edges not that straight, but this frizzy edge, I don't know how to say it, and add the line from the path later on. So here I'm adding the pink for the flowers. Again, I'm super lightly here. I didn't add a lot of color at first because I just wanted to get a sense of where everything had to go. And in the background we have those cherry trees, and I just sketched those blobs. The trees don't have to look the exact same as on the reference picture or on my picture. Just have fun with that and just basically make those dots and shapes, and that's the background. It doesn't have to be too detailed because it's blurry anyways. It will look awesome if it's not that detailed. And there are a lot of those bushes and trees in the background. And I just basically made some lighter and some darker parts because that way you add a little bit more detail and it looks great. So I used some lighter greens and some warmer tones and some darker greens. In case you don't have a lot of colors, you can also just use green and yellow and green and blue. So if you mix green and blue, you obviously get a cooler tone, and if you mix green and yellow, you get a very light tone, so you can vary that. And for the flowers or the leaves in the foreground, I did the exact same thing. I used some different kinds of green. And by the way, this tree in the background on the left side, it looks so weird in the reference picture. I drew it kind of the way it was, but it looks a bit weird. You don't have to add that one if you don't want to, but obviously you can. So I'm just making those dots here, and I took the color directly from the colored pencil. And now I'm adding some dots here, and I'm using masking fluid this time because I kind of wanted to protect the paper, because I'm going in with a lot of green later and I didn't want it to get too dark. You can obviously do this without masking fluid as well and just leave those parts out, but it's easier if you have masking fluid on hand. So I'm adding some more details to this path. It's getting darker and I'm scribbling here One thing with watercolor pencils is that you can be super messy because you're going to blend it anyways. So if you don't have watercolor pencils at home and you want to do this, you can also do this with watercolor and colored pencils. Just do the watercolor parts with watercolor and the rest with colored pencils. It works the same way. Watercolor pencils are kind of useless in that sense, but they're just fun to use, and I think that's the reason why I use them. But I can really recommend these ones because they blend completely. They don't leave any of those strokes if you don't want to have them. They're just amazing. I think that you can't re-wet them. So once they're dry, once you have blended them with water, they're dry. So here I'm adding some more details to those trees, and I think that that you can see those branches, I think that that adds a lot of detail, and I think that that really looks cool. And I also wanted to use the pencils as pencils and not just as watercolor, obviously, because then there's just no point of using them. Or is there? I don't know. Have fun with them. So, but yeah, now I'm adding this strange tree. I still think that it looks strange, but I wanted to make it the way it looked in the reference picture. So adding in more and more detail, just doing the same thing over and over again, basically. I'm looking at the reference picture. Where are the shadows? Where are the warmer tones and the darker tones? Where are the pink parts and where are the green parts? And adding them in. Not perfectly, because it's a painting and it doesn't have to look realistic, or at least I'm not attempting that here. And yeah, but the reference picture helps a lot because I get a general idea where I want to put the lights and the shadows and where I want to put everything. So I added more detail to this path, and now I'm adding more detail to those leaves. And the masking fluid really helped me a lot, because otherwise it would be quite of a hassle to leave out all those parts. You can see that I went over it and I didn't really care a lot. You can do it without masking fluid, it just takes a little bit more patience and time. Adding in more of those branches and trees in the background. I really love the way that the trees in the background look, because they're this kind of mixture between watercolor and colored pencil, and yeah, that's cool. If you have those colored pencils or you intend on buying them, once you have used them, or once you have used them as watercolors the way that I do, where I take the pigment directly from the pencil with the brush, after that you have to sharpen them again, because they won't work the same way once they've been wet. So you can see it here, I did that here. So now I'm adding in more detail to those flowers, and that's super easy. You just add in the darker parts at the bottom of every flower. They are basically circles, but not perfect circles. Don't make them too perfect, because then they won't look as organic. You just add darker parts at the bottom of the flowers, and that way you get that detail and that three-dimensional look. Adding in more details to those leaves and the pathway, more shadows, just where there isn't sunlight going. It's hard to explain, but when you look at the picture, you can see where there's light and shadow, and I tried to basically recreate that a little bit. So this is the finished painting. I really hope that you liked this video, and if you did so, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. I'll see you next week. Goodbye!